trying to figure out the volume of my voice and get used to this, but let's get started. And thank you, everybody, for coming to this first panel in this area here. We are here talking in English today because this is one of the few areas here in the Arvamusfestivalil festival where we are doing English talks. Most of the other ones are in Estonian. So bear with us, that's one thing. And the other one is that you're welcome. You know, everybody else who doesn't know, understand Estonian, that well, we are an international panel, you know, for English and some sort of language. So, today we are here to talk about the mythical creatures called trolls. There's different ways of making those people. And we're basically in the upcoming festival talking about opinions and people who have opinions. And why are they like that? And this is the general gist of this whole thing. And I want to also welcome everybody who's viewing our stream online. I hope there's a million of you out there as well. Let me just go through who is here with us today and introduce myself as well and how it's going to go. My name is Laura Kaufman. I am working right now as an analyst in the Information System Authority. This means that I deal with cybersecurity. My background is also journalism, and I've also been a teacher, so issues, bullying, cyber trolling, especially when this my journalist time as well. We have here a truly great panel. To my right, and we'll go through what English's speciality is, and we will do this as well. To my right, there's some of them are just have strong opinions. generally a higher want to be in touch and understand the way that people were, that was defined on the site, terrible platforms that we were seeing in our mind every day. So since 2014, I've been traveling the globe with some 25 or 30 people. The people on the far right, people on the far left, people that believe in climate change, people that don't believe in climate change, people that harass people because they find it amusing. Why I wanted to do it was because at that time when I started in 2014, a lot of the debate about internet trolls, internet warriors, was about who they were, but very few people were actually talking with them. And that was my goal, to try to understand who they were and get to know them and talk to them about and talk to them and to get to them. So, just before I ask you a follow up question right there as well, let's just make a couple of things and just discuss what we're actually talking about. Who are the trolls and who are, what do they do? So, as I understand, this is a legitimate question of the freedom of speech. Somebody really wants to express their opinion and having a shield, a computer before them actually gives them either anonymity or basically not even anonymity, maybe just protection from somebody who might look down on that opinion. And then there's of course people who are the actual trolls who just do it for fun or are being paid to do it or are just joining in on the action. Is there anything here that you would like to specifically point out that you would like to define separately as well?
No, I think your definition is quite good. Of course, it's a really broad subject in a way, and some different people actually think that my goal and my other was to see something just like the everyday people that were spending hours and hours on the internet every day, and maybe after work or whatever, publishing comments, and many of them are quite extreme. Many of them could be threatening, some of them were against. Some of them were harmless. So the comments that I'm focusing on is mainly everything you can find online.
All right, I'm going to come back to you a little later, and that was just a little bit as well. Christian, tell us about what you've been researching, I understand, especially men. What is it that you are focusing on in your research?
Well, thank you. A lot of my research has to do with understanding the internet. And in 2017, the internet more and more continues to understand whether this is neither free nor democratic, nor is it representative. We know that the two dominant kind of discussions online are done by one heteronormative heterosexual men. That being said, we also know that life more and more is part of harassment, terrorism, and trauma is aimed at arriving to the right place to include religion. Same for the white, we know that it's secondary to black women, and certainly in dealing with the system or with the right of them. In understanding that, all that it boils down to is actually beauty. And my understanding is, aspect of my work was trolling into harassment, into outright terrorism, and I'm trying to analyze that in all the points down to that group of, statistically speaking, 2019 men, adolescent and young men, taking to me that every other group of people in existence, humans around. And my work has to do with understanding why and how, why can't we stop it, and why can't we take it to them?
Okay, so just want to follow up right now. Are they bad people?
I didn't report to the internet, and all of that was to find the people who were. My research tended to say that these people, I mean, at least they understand that's being a work rather
This is actually a good point that Kelly is making to you just in a second, that the safer internet project has been out there for 10 years, 11 years now. 11 years. So the kids that were, that you had targeted, they're already grown up. They're already grown up. They are already in the world among us. And we don't actually know, did this work on them as well? Are those ones that have got in contact with the safer culture? Are those the ones that are not doing the same work? Or, awesome. We hope so, but the question, remains about the education part of this, and the youth part of this, and the adult part of this one. These were from two let's differentiate a little bit. What that code is doing is interesting and important, but the people behind it are the focus of what we're doing here and the focus of a lot of your research here. I'm going to come back to with the same question actually asked Jason. In your travels, your portrait, you portrayed a lot of people who have extreme views online. Are they bad people? I'm just asking the same question, the binary, the good, bad, or, what is the content of badness.
Okay, I think the interesting part of my thinking people is that when I was reading comments from Stephen McStone's survivor in the warrior of strength and tools, we have perceived like these are really bad, terrible people. I think actually in meeting them, stated the opposite. A lot of the people were normal people. They were had a job, they had friends, many of them had families. And we could have a good conversation about like everyday subjects. But as soon as we started talking politics or the subject that they were really interested in, it was we could almost be like flipping a switch. But they could be a bit more complicated, a bit more aggressive. But they did treat me nice. So I think like it's important that we don't just write off every people that are writing stupid things online as bad people or evil people. But that we try to understand why they are doing it.
I'm going to go with the same question. How do you feel if you hear this present as a ghost? There are some really normal people who are adults, but they are writing really mean comments or harassing people. How does that make you feel?
Honestly, it's just that people there is no such thing as normal or not normal. We are all just people, and everyone has normal side and then this side where they are not normal. They're just these people that have this kind of not normal side.
Okay, that's a good way of putting this. Christian, what's up with the mental? So why is it that this surface in your research, or have you seen, and how come
being stuck in the internet. It's the door. Who want things to be as they were like 50 years ago. That was, of course, not such a paradise at the time. I guess not for women, but not for me either, but it's kind of a nostalgic picture of that time. And then there are these progressive people of the progressive group that is pro women's rights, gender equality, pro maybe productive rights. And so on, and that's something that these conservative reactionary people do not stand, they can't take it. And that's one of the reasons why they want to kind of all the time they just want to have this very, very binary system where men used to be men and women, where women and they were there cooking and taking care of children, and now they are coming. The right heterosexual paradise for me is vanishing and they are worried.
That is we know all this. What can we do about it? Or we, if we trust in always that question, who is the weak? What is the kind of level of responsibility to the consciousness of the consciousness of white? If we imagine our projection that it starts early childhood and then ends up, it's the address of the rest of the world, and we have to let it go to that. In the end, not only the inclusion of life, but they are also the
join one human life to set their lives in each other. Action is supporting projects that can be brought to place for example, online discussion forums, but also physical role projects. In the beginning, if you want to write some things that you can do, I'm talking about this word keeping, which is where I really think the list comes to the word that's the best that can be drawn from. And then people. And like, they want to go back to that, even though everybody knows it was a way to get a turn for men and women and people to keep their life. And that is what we have to look at about to understand. So if we can complete ourselves out of that, that is the most important part of the thing. If you want to be consistent, you can do it. And I think that's the
way. You haven't done the same thing, but I'm going
I can't say about the whole part because I don't have such experience. experience. I have not seen it. I have to say, I have had some kind of experience because where I and I ignored it, so it went, but it was a boy. I can say that. But yes, I say, you know, so as has been said, it comes traditional teachings. And it's like that, especially with her older parents. So I can say, to who it does affect it, because I myself have been raised by really older people. And I just think they do not support that. Perhaps we're talking about here. At the moment when you from the future, from the past, I would say, and at that moment, you come to look for these things for yourself. But I can actually say, boys support it less. I have had this experience with my friend that she came out and then she got bucked by boys in her class. Girls, you can do that. So, it's it is. Boys do this more.
If we're talking about young
younger generation, there is teaching, there's school, there's people, there's intervention programs that can be united. What about adults? What is it that politicians or activists or friends or whoever, what is the social circle? What could be done? What should be done to help these people?
I think it's the same thing. One of the guys I mentioned, so like before, he always sent his opinions in a lot of newspapers. But like they were never published. But now when he has a one tools, he can publish it from the other ones. Anyway, I think that is important to note as well that I believe that it is a good thing that we can hear more of the opinions now. To go 20 years ago, because there were maybe silence or not being part of a general discussion before. I think it's important to take back some of the digital arenas that we are able to discuss with them in a civil manner online. But as a matter of these common sections, we're here to assemble. And we need to take the back to this guy is through policy, it's through people engaging themselves. I'm not sure that it is, it's a problem that is not going to go on the way that's up.
But if you're going to say, how come you write a policy to actually moderate, politics and policy to actually moderate the free speech online, how do you feel about this?
It's important to keep people on top of the speech and that the consequences that we're seeing out of hatred and so on is a small burden in the bigger picture that we actually have a well-functioning democracy, that we have free speech, that everybody has the possibility to express their opinion. And that it's important that we differentiate between freedom of speech and harassment, things that are, we have laws against it, but we need to also enforce them. And so I think that police policymakers need to use the law in a more sense than we are doing now. There's a lot of the people I met, maybe they publish hatred online, or hate speech, or death threats online, but they face no consequences. That is the big problem, right?
I suppose that free speech without consequences is actually very free. And, it doesn't make it more free for everybody else. But, you're with the same question. What is, we know so much already, we've done so much research being done into what are these people, what drives them? Why is it? Why is it still a problem? Why can't we?
That's a very important question you're raising. And I think we all need to ask ourselves, why do we let this happen? I mean, there should be ways, and I shouldn't say there are ways, but what I'll tell you, that building the steps to prevent that is not because it's easier for us, it's not really something that we let the internet corporations do because they get money out of it. Are we really hiding behind that? It's really very difficult to have these laws against hate speech because then it's hate speech. It's not like that. We should be able to do something. We should first of all make it right. I mean, this is a real problem that is affecting democracy already so much. And we should be really, really worried. We should be worried about what's happening. I mean, what's happening to speech is it's happening out in Hungary, Poland, for example. Hate speech also threatens free speech, and they are not like, how do I say this? Hate speech is limiting people from talking, so that is censorship in a way that they hinder. They want silence opinions, some people and some opinions, some positive opinions. And there is what we should be doing in really very tonight, just because we are not doing enough. There are many, many ways, many means to tackle this problem, and we are not doing this good, and we need to ask ourselves why.
So the question is basically from me, actually, to your doctor, who is this week? Who, we have the opinion festival here, which is, one thing.
Individual level, everyone has to need to reach the top of this harassment and hate speech comments. We can argue that this is not a good product. But also, as a society, as democracies, we should be able to protect this democracy. So we as developers, as individuals, but we need to think about this also as a broader level. Why are we looking at this? In power. Why are we making this happen? So we need to be able to have laws against that. And it's really, it's difficult. It's really hard to say. But I believe that as teachers, as journalists, as educators, as researchers, as politicians, we need to take responsibility every level of society. Thank you. political activism or in communication and teaching. Right now, we don't have the internet. And 5 years ago, when I saw an active reactive online, when people saw it, or something awful that came, the internet was free because no five companies had to be cleaned up. That is where we are today. We don't have a free internet. And even with Facebook, the people that could have been, so on and so forth, dictate what the internet is used for. And like Peter said, we make money on self-activity. We have that internet that is designed to further more activity, more likes, more dislikes, more comments, more retweets, more thinking, retweets. And that's what we want with the internet. Fine, we can just like, we have a big discussion. That discussion we need right now is what we actually want to do with the internet.
I would say there is some difference that we sometimes talk about some things online. We don't talk about physically in one place, but it can also be because when physically being in one place, it's just so different, it feels different. And, you know, we often rather we prefer to communicate to chatting and writing, not that much to communicate each other. So you don't see others' real emotions, you see the emotions they send, or what they tell you, and you don't see the movement, the body language, and also, like, you're not in one place entirely, and it's just, it's a bit different. But I would say, generally, there is no big difference.
So, basically, what I'm trying to get at is, if you write something,
then you write it, maybe it's easier to correct something the first sentence, or maybe it's just what you are writing, this is the time it's already saying words out, but then you are writing it, so you have more time to think about it. This can be
a difference. Right. So then I want to ask you a similar question about people you portray. Is there a difference for them that, you know, they can actually say something? Showed it to them, and many of them really like, but I didn't mean it that way, and I was a lot harsher, and like, I think that was a big problem. Like, a lot of things that, when they were reading it back in a few weeks and later, it became a lot harsher for them in a way. It became much more direct. And I think that that is an interesting note as well, but maybe it's a bit of a map today. They could almost like it. We have been discussing this in the case of the big problem for many years. From my perspective, we have been able to fix it when it's getting worse. And there's no quick fix to it. And that is like, from my perspective, we can continue discussing it. We need to talk to the people who are actually doing it. We need to face, if we have a neighbor or an uncle who's writing something or a friend online, we need to talk to them, we need to create a dialogue and try to fix it face to face, or a friend to another friend. I don't think necessarily policies are a fixed level for everything. Okay. Sort of a controversial issue of my own, with the whole panel to ask, just to remind the things that we've been doing with them,
what
Thank you.
important for them, because it's really important they do say that.
Okay.
which part of the thing that you do, or you have to set it on the side one day. Good thing that they got it out of the system and they weren't holding it all back and took out too much space. It's a difficult question because it's like there are good consequences to that people are able to express themselves. And there's also like terrible things coming out of it. A couple of you guys said you have a question, that there will be a microphone.
Whenever they post something new, it will get circulated, it will get more popularity, more visibility, more attention, more votes. So it has been actually showed on the screen that, for example, Donald Trump actually got elected for the office because of the not despite of this hate speech. And I think that's happening now in tremendous way in the ready for that parties. The meaner you are, the more votes you get. So misogyny, racism, all that, it's just form and say those things aloud and you'll get votes. So there are consequences and they may be good, so unfortunately.
Everybody can see
and understanding these places.
Yeah, so actually, it's really weird that the same people in the yard are always talking about getting canceled.
So, at the top of this series, expressing opinions online and the consequences resulting from it, there's also another side of that I've seen so quickly in this question. Let's say that the group of online is discussing some sort of media, a movie, or tech, and this is a result that toxic actions that are sort of characters or something that should be objectively wrong. Especially kind of those types of toxic relationships that some people actively support. I've known some people that are really toxic about this type of things. And then I also know other people who are oh yes, I'm aware that it's toxic and I've never wanted to talk about relationships in my life. But here's my question. Why is it that you're not bothering them in the right? Why is not that a deal breaker for you? Maybe you can look at it like, what do you look at? Likes, dislikes, or something like that, dislikes and dislikes. They're all things that say something about you as a person, whether you realize it or not. And what I can try to be respectful about it is you see, there are people who are kind of recalling you in this scenario and still say that you're objecting with wrong. No matter how much that's what you're watching. No, I'm specifically referring to how people like this interact over that it's kind of all about the people's perspective, the mind, or knowledge of things, and how, all I'd say is about people understanding the fact that people's actions and people's thoughts.
Thank you for that question. Why does this little bit go into what Thank you.
that they want to know systems or like intelligence and so on. I see that there's a lot of media being presented as the same media, as the same businesses, the same relationships that are being used and to understand them as good, whereas now it's just going to take the rest of us understand it to be bad. It could be either joke from you or one of those that run around the watch and what do you think that's on? So not these things that are joke and horror from them. This kind of subcontent that you said, this is what we want to do, this is what we want to do. And I don't think that there's a problem inherent in the media. I don't think it's objectively bad. What I think is missing is a broader discussion. If you take some of these movies, joke from this, and then joke from the movie came out, the federal police in the US, the FBI, sent out warnings to movie theaters that this movie might be misunderstood on the inside of terror and violent attacks in movies. Then we have a problem. And I think the problem that we're talking about is that we live in a world that exists in an attention economy. The more attention you can get, the more money you have. It's not about money, it's about the attention. So I do believe that some authors on purpose could add media or content that is, I don't want to say bad, but speaking to a bad narrative that can be misunderstood and then will be misunderstood by half. Criticized for being a little bit misunderstood, and the other half, like Jordan Peterson, or some of the other contemporary, but not quite, authors and speakers. It's not about what you say, it's about the attention that it gets.
So, controversy sells, and the controversy is something that sells not just in media, but also online. In some cases, so they actually thrive on that controversy. Thank you, Gary. Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Sarah.